Here we are on the flight deck just prior to liftoff, and there's liftoff. You'll see the sun. Oh, there's liftoff right there. The first one was the engine starting up. You'll see the roll program here as the sun kind of shines through the cockpit. Right there, the orbiter is going through its roll maneuver, roll program, and the vehicle just flew beautifully. We had a great ride. We had brilliant sunshine coming in through the windows in the front, and it was just a fantastic ride all the way up. Some people have said that sometimes Columbia, they have to do a lot of work on it on the ground, but when it gets in space, it does just does wonderful, and we think that's because she just loves to be in space, because we've got a great vehicle right now, and we're really enjoying it. As you can see down the lower left, there's Mike Anderson coming up from the middeck, preparing for the ET photo that we're going to do once we pitch the orbiter up. And Dave Brown, there on the right, is getting out of his seat and getting his seat prepared to take some video of the external tank. Mike's taking pictures with the F5 camera, and Dave there is getting his parachute out of his seat, kind of getting everything out of the way so that he can then fold his seat down and get in a position to be able to take pictures of the external tank. Dave's making sure he's got all of his settings correct on the camera here, and then getting ready to take a look outside the window and film that external tank. We've got some clips of the external tank coming up here shortly. There's a good shot of the external tank just shortly after we pitched up, and we're looking at it through the overhead windows of the orbiter, as you saw Dave getting and Mike getting ready to do earlier.
The middeck during the ascent, you can see Ilan Ramon on the left side of the screen and Laurel Clark in the middle, and Mike Anderson to the extreme right, and there was liftoff, and you can see all the shaking that happens in very fast sequence as soon as the orbiter launches. This is a view of SpaceHab kind of early in our flight. You can see myself, Kopna, working on the zeolite crystal growth experiment, where we are growing material crystals in space. This particular experiment is from Northeastern University, from Center for Advanced Studies in Microgravity. Laurel Clark is working on the bioreactor experiment. We are growing prostate cancer cells in the bioreactor. You can see Laurel working with the computer interface for the same experiment, trying to keep herself stable in the foot loop that we use on orbit. This study is being originated from Johnson Space Center, and the idea is to be able to grow bigger cells in space and thus be able to differentiate them better. Laurel is performing an analysis of the constituents of the media that is used to feed these cells. She will insert the cartridge that she has filled with the sample into the analyzer, and the analyzer will tell her what it contains. Mike Anderson in this view is working on the advanced respiratory system ergometer. This particular study is being led from the European Space Agency. A number of studies being performed here where the crew members are working on various regimens of breathing protocols. The device on Mike Anderson's hand actually records, amongst other things, the blood pressure also. This is a view from the orbiter mid-deck where the crew members actually live. this scene is being recorded at the time of a handover when the red ship is talking to the blue ship, telling them about what happened during their day. In the background, while the crew is drinking from their drinking bags, you can see the sleep station with one of them with an open door. You can see Rick Husband here in Space Hab, the double research module. He's working on activating the water loop. He has removed one of the panel covers in the aft module, and you can see how he's got his feet hooked under the longitudinal rail there to keep himself stable while he's doing operations in microgravity. You can see the very impressive plumbing underneath this lab floor, while above the floor we seem to be working in peace with all these experiments. Underneath, a lot is happening in terms of systems.